Hello. So I've just started a little bit early just so that we can make sure it's all working. So if you could just comment, if you're watching already, if you could just comment to say that you can hear, that would be really helpful, please. Hello, Pat. Fantastic, thank you, Tricia. Okay, so welcome to the beautiful St. Wilfrid's Church in Preston. That's where Metanoia Project is based, and you're very welcome. I'm really looking forward to praying with you all again this evening. Just to explain, I'm in church because we have a homeless drop-in that happens at this time every week. So that is happening at this moment with some of our volunteers. So if you hear banging about or voices or anything like that, it's coming from the other end of church where there's lots of people. It's very busy tonight, so there could be noise, so I apologise for that. But we'll just lift up all of the guys, our volunteers, and all those who have come to visit this evening. We'll lift them up in our prayer this evening as well. So welcome. I can see that people are starting to tune in. I think it's just gone seven, so I'm going to make a start. So last time I talked for about 10 minutes. I think I was just really nervous, so this time I'm not going to do that. We're going to start singing quite quickly. So I just want to say that what I was praying about, I was asking the Lord what did he want us to sing, what did he want us to pray with, and the feeling I got was just a real sense of his goodness, his real goodness for us, and his love for us. And I think that as at charismatic conferences and events, we're good at sort of shouting out, you know, God is good all the time God is good. But when things go wrong, it can be really easy to forget that God is always good. You know, he's never anything other than good. He's always good. And if we really believe that, that has a massive impact in how we approach our faith, how we approach our life, everything that we do. If we deep down truly believe that God is good and that all he wants is good for us. And we've heard beautifully this week the blessing sung by all the churches. It's been a wonderful thing. And the repetitive line in that he is for you. You know, that's really important. He is for us. He's for me. He wants good for me. And like I say, that changes how we approach other people, how we turn to God, how we approach him. So we put our trust in him. Let's sing, let's praise him with all of our being. And my prayer for you is just that you would know the goodness of God this evening, and that it would really speak deeply into your heart. Let's praise the Lord together.
Stop the Lord, oh my.
are the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords. Come. Lord, we open our hearts this evening. Come, Lord. Come, Holy Spirit. Move in us. We give you permission to take control now, Lord.
Thank you.
lift up your name. You are awesome, awesome. You understand, you call us to be your children, and you bring us into relationship with you. Awesome God.
Great, your love was great.
God, you can do all things. You're always working for us, always working for our good. We believe in you, we put our trust in you. Moving here in front of me, moving. In his recent address, in his recent letter, Father Raniero Cantalamessa, the papal preacher, said, "The greatest miracles of the Holy Spirit are not obtained in response to our supplications, but in response to our praise." And I was really reflecting on this, that, you know, sometimes we ask, but actually it's when we praise that things change. It changes the atmosphere, it changes the spiritual realm. It doesn't change God, he doesn't change ever, but it does change us. And I was just thinking that where, you know, we all need breakthroughs in our lives at the moment. Where do you need a breakthrough? We need things personally, we need things nationally, we need things internationally. We need things in our churches. So where do we need breakthrough today? And let's get that breakthrough by changing the spiritual realm, by changing ourselves through our praise. So let's lift up our praise to the Lord for that breakthrough. So whatever it is you need breakthrough for, you know, I'm praying particularly for breakthrough in the local church here, particularly for something for our project here in Preston. I really need God to work, need him to act. But I believe it. I believe that he will. So let's lift that up in our next song. Let's really ask for that breakthrough. You're I give you this church, the church in Preston, our bishop, all those who make decisions, Lord. Just put my trust in you that you are breaking through, that you are making a way.
Now
however difficult a situation feels, however impossible, you know, God is the God of the impossible. He makes a way where there seems to be no way. So we claim that victory for our situation in this country at the moment with the coronavirus all over the world. Lord, we claim your victory there. But Lord, help us to see your victory, not what we want to see. Now, as I was just praying, I really felt that God was saying, his victory doesn't always look like our victory. It's always a victory for us, but not the victory perhaps that we're expecting, perhaps how we expect it to look. But to trust him. He is our God. He is good. If we really believe that he is good, then it's always going to be the thing that is even better than we could ever imagine. So it can be a real barrier to believing God's goodness if we don't see what we want to see when we want to see it. So I just wanted to sing this next song almost as a prophecy over you. Just to hear these words, to allow the Father to speak to you. This is God speaking to you this evening, reminding you of his goodness. So just maybe close your eyes, put out your hands, just allow the Father to speak to you, to bring healing, to bring release. But let the Father's love really speak into your heart, his goodness speak to you today.
I will answer, oh, you.
just let the Lord minister to us for a moment. Let's be surrounded by his love. Today is the feast of Our Lady of Fatima. And I was just thinking about her complete trust in the Lord, how much we can learn from her. She completely surrendered all of her plans, all of her life, her body, soul, everything, surrendered it completely to the Lord. She must have trusted his goodness so much, so fully. To just allow herself to be used in such a wonderful way that blessed the whole of creation. So let's surrender, like Mary. Let's surrender all of ourselves to that. Whatever it is God is doing in us, whatever he's breaking through in our lives, whatever he's speaking to us this evening, let's surrender to him fully. In the letter to the Romans, St. Paul writes about Abraham, about his faith, and this really stood out to me early when I was praying. He said this: counting on the promise of God, Abraham did not doubt or disbelieve, but drew strength from faith and gave glory to God, fully convinced that whatever God promised, he has the power to perform. So whatever God has promised us in our lives, he has the power to perform it. We need to trust that he is working, that he is doing things for our good. He has the power to do it. We just need to have the faith to receive that gift. So let's receive that this evening. I don't know where the time goes. We will skip through a few to the end. So let's put our trust in God as his beloved children. remember the goodness of God. Let's remember the freedom that he brings us. Let's remember all the ways that he brings breakthrough in our lives. And let's trust that he has. That something has changed tonight through our praise. That he has done something different. That he has changed us. He has changed our reality. That something has happened because of our prayer. And let's sing of his goodness.
This is running out.
glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. So go and believe in the goodness of God, and I look forward to seeing you next week with whoever else we're worshipping with. God bless.